study on the reaction. First of all, I have a this. So let's take the reaction. The context of the community of the beatitude. I think I have talked about the context behind it. From reading and analyzing the community behind the gospel. You look at the gospel, there are signs, markers that will tell you that the community behind the gospel is whom Jesus, Matthew, is presenting Jesus to talk to them. Okay, do you see that? Kasi, what do we know about the community of Matthew to whom he was, if not through his letter? Okay? So, it's a community of believers who are reviled, persecuted, maligned falsely, accused on account of their faith. You will see that in the text, on account of their values, held on account of their worship, on account of their ethics, on account precisely of their faith. The verse 11 of blessed are you when people revile you, persecute you, utter all kinds of evil against you falsely. But take note on account of me. On account of me. I think we have talked about almost. Blessed are you on account of me. So in other words, on account of their belief. We have seen that. That is, see that in verse 11. Okay? So, consequent of this, you have these people are actually mourning. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. But take note of this word, penthuntes. This word, penthuntes, mourn, penthuntes. Magtaryo yung hoy, penthuntes. That is verse 4. Penthuntes. He has lack of study, parang sayak chabaw. Thirsting, like here the first programming students, But the object is not food, it's the righteousness. Somewhere towards the end of the context of the Sermon on the Mount, search kingdom of God. See first kingdom of God and His righteousness. Ito ang context ng Sermon on the Mount and the righteousness. All the rest of you. And what do you markers mo na karma. So, in the context of sufferings, children crying, yet you are, that's why I'm telling you, this is about in respect to spirit guru. Okay? Hanging lang now. Depart mo na yung first, this is the first, di ba? In the Beatitudes of Beatitudes, first is less than the soul in spirit. Take note, very interesting is for them is the kingdom of heaven. Kingdom, we will talk about that. The major term in Matthew is about the kingdom. Then you have terms of human spirit, but it could be about them. Okay? So, blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness in the day. We move forward. We talk about this righteousness that they are thirsting for, hungering for, looking for, even in the midst of pain, crisis, in the midst of persecution. What is this righteousness? Take note of these three others. I have inverted that, but the truth is, blessed are the merciful, 7 yan. Blessed are the peacemakers, 9 yan. Blessed are the pure of heart, 8. Ito yung ito sa tatang, di ba? Just read it. The context of pain, persecution, context of being excluded, searched, and on account of him, no? On account of his words, on account of his values, on account of his worldview, in other words, the injunction is blessed are the peace, are the merciful. Because those who will be merciful, they will receive mercy. Then, blessed are the peacemakers. Because these two peacemakers, they will put children. Blessed is the middle. Blessed is the middle. It's a rhetorical style in Matthew. Remember, you find that also in Matthew, the woman suffering from
hemorrhage.
But that is embedded in the story of just going to
Jairus. Daughter.
The first part is the report is almost dead. Right? The resumption of the almost dead is when he went and arrived the house, he is dead. Right? In between is spliced the story of
memories.
Woman is about life, resurrection. Itong story of, you know the drama there, diba? How many years, suffered from the body, has only of human intervention, it only has become almost like a terror. It has only gotten worse. But touching him, only I could touch. Sino yun? Sa disciples ng Philippe. Nahanap mo ba? Siyempre, hindi alam yung ang disciples na yung writer of course, a rhetorical style. Rhetorical style to redefine precisely the struggle of death and life. This is a rhetorical style of man. It's placed in a self-serving message. Place this inside. say, you have a context of conflict, segregation, persecution, so forth and so on, injunction is necessary. Search for righteousness. The context, remain merciful, remain peacemaker, but that is defined by purity of heart. Defined by the purity of heart. Peace is defined by the purity of heart. These should be going. They will be God. Okay? So when you look at the when you look at this, and this is the first part, the Beatitudes. This is the identity, supposedly. This is the identity. But in the context of pain and segregation, that's why this could be lost. Easy. When assault, you say an assault, but immediately after, remember the narrative, immediately after the Beatitudes, the parable of the sword. But the context of the parable of the soul is not about the soul as a soul. It is about a soul losing identity. This could be the context of the Beatitudes. Suffering, pain, salvation. This identity is basically lost. Di ba? Ako ba naman sa topi? Merciful. Paano? Ano niya, di ba? So you have ikaw na peacemaker, peacemaker, peacemaker or what, whatever, no? You can in the same context then and now, but that is precisely where the challenge is. So notice that in verse 5, the Beatitudes itself, although it's parang a list, a list sa mga utang, that's a simple list, but actually that is identical, the pharmacodynamics. It's about a community segregated, persecuted, suffering, parang marginalized, but, and there is so much pain going through, and here comes Matthew presenting Christ as though on the hill, like Moses, saying, in terms of spirit, blessed are you, poor. How is it? First for life, we have in the context of pain, mercifulness, peacemaker, unity of heart. By the unity of heart, Christ's fundamental demand for a persecution of the very, I know that it's so you have forgiveness from the heart, mercifulness from the heart, and form of peace. This we define terms of spirit poor. Remember the imagery. Seeking, right? Thirsting and hungering. So, parang unimaginable. You are persecuted. You are going through difficulties. You are going through. Yet the Lord presents and says, search and thirst and hunger, not for agreement, not for to get even. These are facts. That's why immediately after this Beatitude, the parable of the soul becomes so powerful and powerful. I hope you get the principle. And then it says, you are a soul of the Spirit. If you want a Beatitude, ano po na nabito makaryos?
Makaryo.
The literal text is makaryos. Then makaryoy. So, if your name is
Makaryo. Makaryo. You have to live this identity. Otherwise, parang the host will say, you are just like a scarecrow. You look like a man, but you are not a man.
Scarecrow.
Your name is Felix. 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 It is happy. How can I call you Felix when your face is Felix, you don't look happy. Anyway, no. So you have here. I hope you get the. No, I think the Greeks had question there.
I told you.
Well, it's very, very difficult really to conceive physical assault losing its taste. Yeah. Unless ang pagkamalan nyo yung salt na yun ay tawas o hindi sa buk. Tawas pa rin. Tawas pa rin. Sa Bisaya, tawas. So you know where I come from. Tawas. Tawas. Ano mo rin? I learned my Cebuano in Baguio. So you know the irony, no? Well, it's easy, difficult for the physical soul to lose its taste. Sometimes it's much easier for a believer to lose this identity of the reality. Makes her suffering, going for the Christ who says, which tries to meet his heart, namely, from the purity of heart comes the peacemaker, the person of the context of pain. So that's it. Parang there is some sense of sarcasm in that metaphor of soul. When a text is written, kasi, many things is lost. You don't see the face behind the form. Sana nakikita natin si Kristo. Okay, mo pa na rin siya. May sarkasap. Sarkastic camera. The salt from here. Smile. The salt loses its taste. That many things is lost. But when you see that, sarcastic happening. Precisely because, or it could also be that Christ is simply presented by Matthew to challenge them. That's why the fifth day experts they can read things from different perspectives. Anyway, you please visit the point. Now, how recovering the lost identity? It simply means ironical living of the theatricals. There is no really other way. That's why the next text. You have heard it said that I say to you. You have heard it said I say to you. You have heard it said I say to you. We can recover from the Latin perspective, the law is a means to recover this identity. That's why you have there in the case of conflict and misunderstanding that the first there is about hunger, you have heard it said, you shall not murder. So, context of conflict, misunderstanding,
then you have, when the easiest way out is really murder, murder. That's why you have heard he said, you shall not kill. Then he counters and says, but I say to you, he takes away, he focuses on, radically, the first step is radically rooting out of anger, the abuse of words, say, raka. Then insults, name calling. Take that off, because this is a means of going back to the metaphor. Making the soul, recovering the lost soul, or recovering identity. You bring that back. When issues, it is interesting, setting issues in work. As a brother, I think that's don't. Oh, I'm sorry for going to be civil, huh? Sa hapon, sa bulagahan.
Bulagahan.
Merong may tatlo na nalo sa kwan, one for all or for one, nalo sa babae. Interview sa amin na, oh, kita kang ka, sir, kung si person. Kung bakit ka, di ba hindi ka, at, ano ka sabihin mo para sa mga pamangkin o tatlo sa ito? Okay lang, sabal ka, tali na, kung tuwa niya ako. Pero ako mga pamangkin na nakaangkin na hindi sa kanila. Yung property nila inangkin, pero he was saying this, parang kumatawa, sabi niya, masaya ka na lang kami, nagkaw ka na pamangkita ganun. Pero tinitinan mo yung smile, totoo. Terms quickly with your abuser while you are on the way. Diba? You have familiar with that. When you talk about court cases, in other words, you have equal claims. Equal claims, meron kang right, meron silang right. Diba? Ang kataluhan kayo kasi yun talaga yung may kuhan. May ari dyan. It says, the injunction is come to terms quickly. When you read this text, although seemingly, the text will point out na pag matalo ka sa case, if you sumin ka, you pay the last penny. But you notice that there's a concept that the injunction is for the believers, do the first book, and the first book. You cannot understand that if it's not about the attitude. You cannot understand that unless you connect it to the attitude. And the concept of recovering the basis of a soul that is lost, is lost, and the metaphor. How can it stay still? Going back, going, tatlo pa sila, diba? Anger, tapos, in the middle, is really interesting. This is important. When you are offering your gifts to the altar, to remember your brother and sister, as something against you, give your gift to them for the altar, no questions. You know, it's not even talking about you having something against you. That you realize it. This is, you need to take this literally, but it's a guy's name. It's not a guy's name. It's not a guy's name. But tayo after 10-15 minutes. Magkakagalit yung pareksa. I think here the concept in here is about theory. Take the first rule. You notice that the first part there must take away after. Take away the don't resort to insulting words. Don't resort to. Then you have the court cases. To the first rule. You notice that it could be that the reasons for all this is about really the religious piece of it. If you're a new face, when you are able to come to face with your offerings. Now, literally or not, I would take it not itself. Because your theology, you know, we know that when it was said, you have to be come in for God. But the injunction is very, very clear. You want to recover your love, you want to become the soul of the message. Recover the reality. How is it? So that's the difference. There are many instances that I was telling you that you notice that they are all pictures presented, you know? All pictures. I'm here, but not so. But look at the arrangement. This is in the middle. It shows that the glass structure you're familiar with. The middle defines. What defines the conciliation of the movement really is the religious movement. Because this is a moment of the philosophy. The beatitude. Okay? Yeah. Now, how do you translate the catechesis? Ako? Saan yung buod? Paradigm. Hindi yung new paradigm. The different context. And this will transform the challenge. You cannot understand that unless you have less than mercy. They will receive mercy. It goes back to that. Pag nakita niyo sa scriptures niyo, huwag niyo alam po talaga yung Bible niyo. Nasa bahay na lang. At palimutan nyo na yung breviary. Mas dala nyo pa yung camera kesa sa breviary. Wala, nandito na sa loob yung breviary.
Cellphone.
Dapat cellphone. Pero camera ka dulo kung kami tinira sa camera. Sinabi na, nandito na kasi sa loob yung breviary. But anyway, wala tayo. Anyway, you cannot. Yeah. Sunday, I was coming because of the Bible. The Bible is in the Quran. Think of the world of light, huh? Because you are the whole earth, okay? Light, though, to show what you are like. But when you let it speak up, again, that metaphor is picking up towards the middle. If your light is here, how much darkness? If your light is darkness, how much evil is there? That's the, you know, the treatment of text is not only given na yung the better side. It's focusing on where the weakness. You follow? It's just like you're the salt of the earth, talking as a human. It has lost its taste. You are the light of the world. If you pick up that, you say, the light of the world, you will see light. If you pick up, then if your light is darkness, how much evil is there? If you have, anyway, I will not touch that because it's I'm talking about the cares, right? There are two masters. So how much? So which is like the two masters you can serve, Satan and evil? When you the cares, you worry so much that God has counted the number of your days. And the birds, they don't fall without disturbing. It's about falling. These are all pictures. You have to understand the picture from the context of the narrative. Okay. Now, another retaliation. You've heard it said, eye for eye, tooth for tooth. Yes. Alam naman natin na yung retaliation is it moves from injury from 1 to 10 first